California continues to be inundated by storms, and millions of residents remain under flood watch. Western New York is still recovering from last month's historic blizzard that dumped more than 4 feet of snow on Buffalo. Lara Barrón-López is back and examines the frequency of extreme winter weather and the debate about its potential links to climate change.
Longtime Buffalo residents had never seen a winter storm quite like this one. Morris Singer III says for much of the city's Christmas week blizzard, he was doing wellness checks as part of a volunteer group in his East Buffalo neighborhood. He shot this video in near whiteout conditions.
And you've lived in Buffalo your whole life, right? I mean, have you ever seen a storm like that?
Not like that, especially with the wind. The wind just made it just extra worse than what it was.
Morris later found out that his own father was among the more than 40 residents killed in and around Buffalo as a result of the blizzard. 65-year-old Morris Singer Jr., a man known for his flashy suits, died trying to walk to a grocery store as the storm hit. His body was later found in a snowbank.
He was so like flamboyant, larger than life, wanted to be seen. So his personality was the same. So, you know, they told me he was going to the store, and unfortunately, the store is only 2 blocks over, and he didn't make it.
The blizzard conditions, coupled with 70-mile-per-hour winds, were a catastrophic combination. Climatologist Adam Smith calculates the financial costs of weather-related disasters for NOAA's National Centers for Environmental Information.
And unfortunately, the late December 22 winter storm cold wave was, in some parts of the country, a storm of a lifetime. Just the hurricane force winds around Buffalo and just the intense snow squalls, it was quite remarkable.
Smith says the blizzard was just one of 18 separate billion-dollar weather and climate disasters in the United States last year. And he believes it could end up being the costliest winter weather event in roughly 2 years when nearly 250 people died in Texas.
And so in 2021, February was the most costly winter storm cold wave on record, which we remember the Texas energy grid froze. Many other states experienced a lot of damage from just the cold. It was over a $20 billion event.
While it's increasingly clear that other severe types of weather, like the recent flooding in California, droughts, and longer wildfire seasons, all can be linked to global warming, the fingerprints of man-made climate change on extreme winter weather is less obvious. That debate often centers around the Arctic, a region warming nearly 4 times faster than the rest of the world.
The biggest changes we're seeing with climate change are happening in the Arctic. I think there's a connection.
Climate scientist Dr. Judah Cohen studies the links between Arctic warming and disruptions to the polar vortex, the swirling winds above the North Pole.
Our argument is that changes in the Arctic are leading to more of these disruptions of the polar vortex, which increases our risk of severe winter weather.
For most Americans, winters are getting both shorter and warmer across much of the U.S. Average winter temperatures have risen by at least 2 degrees since the 1970s. But Judah Cohen says something else is happening.
What people are actually experiencing is a warmer, shorter winter punctuated by more of these severe winter weather events.
Cohen's research is not fully agreed upon among scientists. Some argue that cold weather, even when severe, could simply be a natural deviation from a general warming trend. What's clear, the increasing frequency of extreme weather means more Americans will likely be impacted going forward. And some groups will be hit much harder than others, says Adam Smith.
Most everyone is vulnerable to some extreme or combination of extremes. And certainly people who have highest socioeconomic vulnerability to these different extremes often might not have, you know, a vehicle to evacuate. They might not have a home insurance policy to help recover from damages. They might not have the social fabric to help them rebound after these extremes.
There's an old adage in the African-American community that says when white people get a cold, Black people get pneumonia.
Urban studies professor Henry Louis Taylor Jr. says that Buffalo's mostly Black East Side was especially vulnerable to this blizzard. Many residents there live in older homes and often rely on walking.
Already we know that Blacks represented about 50% or more of the fatalities in a region where they represent only about 14% of the population. This was something you had never seen before. The messaging was never there. It was never there that walking could kill you.
A driving ban remains in effect.
While the city of Buffalo did institute both the driving ban and urged residents to stay home during the blizzard, Morris Singer III says it was a message that never reached his father.
This is probably the worst storm that any of us have experienced in our lifetime. And we just didn't know any better because people were still going out. Like my father, still thinking that, hey, this is all right. I can walk to the store. I can make it. That this isn't going to kill me.
Does that make you angry with the city of Buffalo for how they handled the storm?
I'm a little frustrated because I still think it's a lack of accountability with 43 people dying.
Like many in Buffalo, Singer says he hopes last month's blizzard will be a wake-up call for the city as it prepares for future extreme storms. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Laura Barrón-López.